Okay, I know it takes a few moments for folks to get in here. So everything that I'm saying, if you don't, you don't get it, I will definitely put that in the chat for you. Welcome to our virtual college fair. This is incredibly important that you get to hear from these experts. These are the keys to their institution. They know all the things about getting more acquainted with their institutions and seeing if it's a best fit for you. Pay attention to that chat because I definitely encourage you to look there. They will be putting their contact information, any important emails or websites that you may need to have. And it, just for your sake, this is recorded. You can access this at strivescan.com. All of that information will also be in the chat as well. Our panelists cannot see or hear you, so please utilize that Q&A button that's either at the bottom or the top of your screen. That is a good way for them to be able to type that answer directly to you, or you know, for them to answer live depending on where they're at in their presentation. All right, and all the extra information that you need, again, I will put everything into the chat. With that, we're gonna kick it off with Blackburn College.
All right, hello everyone. My name is Neely Ritzel, and I am one of the admission counselors here at Blackburn. Let me get my screen shared. Okay. Maybe. Can you guys see that?
No, you're not sharing your screen.
It's not working.
That's okay. How about if that's okay, we can move on and I can add you to after Columbia, if that's okay.
Yes, please. Thank you. Sorry.
Yeah, absolutely. So next up, we have Illinois College.
All right, everybody. Hi, how are you all doing? Let me just go ahead and share here really quick. My name is Sarah Jean Gilbert. I am the Associate Director of Admission here at Illinois College. Happy to see you all today. Well, not really see you, but happy that you're here today to go through a few things about what your experience could be like at Illinois College. We are a small private liberal arts college located in central Illinois. We like to say that we're kind of a private liberal arts college that is actually focused more on the future and mostly focused on your future. So we want to help you graduate ready for whatever you want to do once you leave college. So we're going to give you all sorts of really great experiences that can help bring you through into whatever that next step is going to be. We have a lot of different things that we're offering our students. I'll talk a little bit more about internships and hands-on learning a little bit in my presentation, but 100% of our students participate in some sort of that kind of learning, which really does help them to kind of push forward into whatever they want to do next. We are, for a small school, we are definitely have a good diversity of our students. About 28% of our students identify as students of color. And we do have good representation throughout the United States, representing 32 states in our student body, as well as 26 foreign countries. So we do have that good diversity, even though we are located in central Illinois, which is great. We have about 50 plus undergraduate majors on our campus. Some of them are traditional liberal arts majors and some of them are not. In fact, our most popular major is biology, followed by business, psychology after that, and then education. We have lots of good, strong majors. And the benefit of that small college experience is you can actually work really closely with your professors, possibly on some research, possibly on an internship, that sort of thing. So you can get a lot of great experiences and really get to know your professors here on our campus. The average class size is 17 students, and I would say the majority would be much smaller than that. And then our student to faculty ratio is 13 to 1. Our faculty are really involved in our students' experience, and even from the beginning. So we really do want to put them out front. They decided to work at a place like IC because they wanted to have that impact on their students. Nearly 100% of our graduates are onto their career of choice or going on to grad school after within 1 year of their graduation. And all of our incoming students are paired with academic coaches once they start here at IC. In terms of where we are located, Jacksonville, Illinois, you can see in kind of that central west central portion of Illinois, we're about 30 miles from Springfield, Illinois, which is the capital of our state. We're a smaller town, so at about 25,000 people. On our campus, we're at about 1,100 students, and we love that number. Might get a little bit bigger, but that's kind of where we are at. In Jacksonville, it's a great place to live. People are friendly, lots of things to do. Just wanted to mention that because sometimes it's hard to tell where things are located, and we are not located very near to Chicago. In terms of all the things that we're offering our students, internships are big. We want to make sure you get into a career of choice really early on so you can see what you might be doing there. We also want our students to be involved in research. So we have lots of opportunities to work closely with our faculty members to get some research experience, which is good for that graduate ready portion. If you want to go into grad school, if you want to go to medical school, any of those things, or if you want to go into your career of choice, that will all look really great on your resume. We also want our students to be involved. Our students are heavily involved on our campus, and that is a big portion. And we also offer international travel opportunities that will be starting up here in the summertime. So our students are looking forward to that as well. We do have a lot of different value that we want to show you today. So our textbooks are included in our tuition. We offer very generous scholarship and financial aid opportunities for our students. And we do have a finish in 4 guarantee that guarantees that our students can graduate in 4 years. We wanted to mention that it's not too late to apply. We still have scholarships available for our students if you are interested in possibly applying for fall 21. So make sure you get your application in. There's a couple of places where you can apply. And we are test score optional. We've been test score optional for about 10 years. So make sure that you are going ahead and not including your test score if you don't want it included, or if you don't have one, that is no problem. And our merit scholarships, everyone who is admitted receives between $12,000 and $24,000 in scholarships from us. And that is guaranteed all 4 years of your experience at IC. We have additional scholarships for out-of-state students. So here they are too, Trailblazer, $2,000 annually. And then if you're able to apply and be admitted, complete the FAFSA, and then visit either virtually or in person, you get $2,000 as well. This is our contact information. Please feel free to reach out to us. We will try and reach out to you as well. We want to make sure that you're having a good experience in your transition as well as when you get onto campus here. So let us know if there's anything we can do for you. And I have been really excited to talk with you today. Thanks so much, everybody.
All right. Thank you so much. Next up, we have Illinois Wesleyan University.
All right. Good morning, everybody. My name is Andrew Starnes, and I'm the regional admission rep for Illinois Wesleyan University. I do live in East Tennessee, so I do have the pleasure of working with students from the South. I know some of the states that you all are tuning into are in my territory, so definitely looking forward to hopefully getting a chance to connect with some of you in the future. Looking forward to spending the next couple of minutes here to talk a little bit about IWU and some of the information that helped get us to top 10 nationally in job placement, and why we were recently named the number one hidden gem college of the Midwest by One College publication. So a lot to cover, so let's dive on in. With Illinois Wesleyan, we are a small, deeply rooted liberal arts university. We're located in the town of Bloomington. That's in Illinois, about 2.5 hours south of Chicago. So the Bloomington normal area has about 130,000 residents. So we're a good sized community, not middle of nowhere America by any means. And with our classroom sizes, they're about 16 on average. Since we have about 1,700 undergrads, that allows us to keep things on the small side. You're not gonna see this. You're not gonna get the large lecture room style stadium seating. You're definitely gonna get a lot less lecture and more discussion. Very quality discussion, really emphasizing the value of the education, particularly the liberal arts education. So we want to make sure you get your questions answered in class, have good quality conversations with your peers. And if you're looking for research opportunities, especially for grad school, we are an undergrad only college. So there are no grad students at our school. So usually about 25% students on any given semester are involved in graduate level research with their main professor. So with IW, we are broken up into three main colleges. We do have our School of Nursing, almost two decades of 100% job placement, one of the finer nursing programs around, direct admit. We have our College of Fine Arts, just renowned opportunities in our fine arts, particularly with our School of Theater Arts. We have a nationally ranked musical theater program, brings in a lot of applications from my territory alone. So just different paths in our theater. Can't say enough about our music. It has so many opportunities from the BME to the BM degrees. We have our Bachelor of Arts across the board, and then our School of Art. Just so proud of all the opportunities that you can get from our fine arts side. And then of course, our main College of Liberal Arts does contain the main 80 major minor combinations that we do have. Everything from a pre-engineering physics track to pre-med, psychology, political science, you name it, we usually have it, or a path that we can get you on into grad school to help you in your career. Now at IW, we did take a lot of pride in trying to become a diverse campus. Two of our last three classes were the most diverse in history. This class is actually leading the way among them all. So we are very, very excited about what we are doing to help try to make sure we're being a very inclusive campus. Right now, we got about a third of students, our students of color on our campus. We do things from pre-orientation services through our Office of Diversity and Inclusion, special graduation ceremonies. We're an interfaith campus with our chaplain. And then, of course, even for financial aid, we have over a third of our students, first gen in the last class alone. So we're going to try to do everything we can to be a very welcoming campus and environment for all students. Our campus life, I already mentioned our size, but even though we are a smaller school, we resemble a lot of our bigger university counterparts in the way that we have our campus life and organizations. Over 120 different active, big and small on campus that are student run. We do have Greek life, so we do have sororities and fraternities on campus. Theatrical productions, just so many different things that our students can get involved in. With our housing, we have three different main types of residence hall housing, including the Greek life themed houses as well. So there's just so many different ways to get involved coming in, whether you have options or you don't know where to start, we can help out with that for sure. We are D3 NCAA, 24 different varsity sports teams, very competitive. We're in the CCIW, tend to be very strong across our athletic sports. Men's basketball just won the tournament a few weeks ago. So we love to celebrate all the different ways to get involved. And even if you don't have athletic interest, it's still great to come out and support fellow Titans as we are doing work on the field or court. We also do have esports as well. So if you're interested in gaming, you can potentially get recruited for that opportunity. With financial aid, 95% of our students receive financial aid. I tell everyone, don't be intimidated by the fact of us being a private school. We usually do a lot of ways to try to make sure the schools can be very affordable. Usually our scholarships do go as high as $34,000, and they are renewable each year based on GPA and scores. Just to let everyone know, our average was a 26 ACT, 1210 SAT, and a 375 GPA last year. So if you're at that range or higher, you'll be in great shape to be admitted and then receive, of course, higher end financial aid. We are test optional right now as well too. So for our juniors, the next step would be to apply. The application would go live in August. We are on the Common App. We have our own application. It is a free application, so we keep the process very, very simple. And then my main contact information is in the top left. So if you want to reach out to me, feel free to do so if you have questions after this presentation. And just to let you know, we are doing in-person campus visits safely through spring and summer, virtual visits as well. So there's a lot of ways to get connected and stay in touch with the campus. So if you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out, and we'll look forward to staying in touch, and have a good rest of your day.
All right. Thank you so much. Next up, we have Millikin University.
Just a second. Share my screen here. Awesome. So my name is Gavin Halpin, and I am a St. Louis regional recruiter for Millikin. So I work with students in a variety of about a dozen states in the Southeast, but welcome to the Illinois school party here for the 6x6. So to start, Millikin's located in Decatur, Illinois. For those of you unfamiliar with where Decatur is located, if you see the state of Illinois map at the bottom, that blue icon, we are very close to some of the previous schools mentioned. We're about as central as you can get, being in between Springfield, Illinois, the state capital, and Champaign, Illinois, where the University of Illinois is at. But Decatur, the population is about 70,000 for the surrounding area. And there's a great working relationship between the Decatur community and our campus community. For example, if you look in the top right, you'll see a picture of our downtown Decatur area that has fun restaurants and shops, but it also has several spaces that our students and our campus community are utilizing every day in the form of student-run ventures. So one of the big focuses is for our students to immediately be applying what they're learning. And several of those examples are, we have a student-run copy shop located downtown. We have a student-run art gallery that's continuing to rotate alumni work, but also current student work. And we also have a black box theater that is every process within putting on a show, selecting a show, casting it, and even potentially if the students can make a profit, they do so within that student-run venture. So it's a great opportunity for our members of our community to interact with the campus, but also it's not uncommon to see members of the community on our campus for, we are a Division III school, for athletic events or for lectures or for a variety of performances as well. I know many schools can tout a variety of rankings. I won't read all of these to you, but the one that I think we're the most proud of is that third one listed and being throughout this last year recognized as the number three best college in Illinois to land you a job. Knowing that there are many options within the Midwest and even just within the state of Illinois, we have a very career-focused approach to advising our students if they are seeking to be, you know, on that four-year plan with us. We want the dream goal to be that when they walk across the stage at graduation, the plan is already in place for either going on to that grad school or landing a job. So it's great to receive some recognition for that. Here's a good snapshot of any and all things Millikin. We are that small private liberal arts school with 2,000 total students. Our average class size is 15, and then our student to faculty ratio is 10 to 1. No situation would have you being taught by a grad student or a TA. Every class will be taught by an individual faculty member who most likely has a degree at the top of their field. If you see the top right-hand corner, you'll see we have 50 plus academic programs. I'll break down the individual colleges in just a minute. And then echoing what our similar conference foe, rival Illinois Wesleyan said, we are in the CCIW as a Division III institution with a great emphasis in being a student athlete and continuing to do something you love at a very competitive level. The CCIW is one of the most competitive Division III conferences across the board. Great for our students to continue to do something they love and obtain a degree throughout that process. So I mentioned the 50 plus academic programs. Here are the four individual colleges and schools that Millikin offers. So we have that College of Arts and Sciences that's gonna have your humanities within it, but also your standard sciences. So you'll see your communication, your history, political science, but also your standard biology, chemistry, and so on. I always like to make the distinction that with us, if a student comes in and says, I'm gonna major in pre-med, your major is going to be biology, but you're going to be advised on a pre-professional track by a secondary advisor to make sure that you are at or above the credentials needed for that dream med school or vet school or so on. So I always like to make that distinction for students and families. Next, we see our College of Fine Arts. This is where we see the majority of our volume of applications each year. We do have a top 10 ranked BFA musical theater program that we see a large amount of interest from multiple states nationwide and internationally, but also within that College of Fine Arts is a school of music, art, and arts technology, three individual schools there that we see a lot of interest for. Next, we have the College of Professional Studies that houses the School of Education, our School of Nursing, and then our Exercise Science and Sport program. And then we have our Tabor School of Business, which houses a variety of programs within that individual. So we have the standard business administration, but we also have international business, accounting, finance. It's a very flexible school as regards to students picking up an additional minor, or maybe even double majoring, so something that's very doable. When it comes to opportunities for involvement, similar to the other institutions you've heard, a smaller school does have many opportunities. So we do have 90 plus student organizations. Think of the individual opportunities for involvement as individual bubbles. On average, a Millikin student is going to be involved in three things. Even the student that comes in and says, I'm only gonna be in the honors program, or I'm only gonna play baseball. Chances are over the course of their 4 years, they end up dipping their toe in a variety of bubbles on our campus, whether that's performance-based, honors-based, athletic and wellness-based, so on and so on. So great amount of options for our students. One of those options is the opportunity to study abroad. We see students typically within their junior year take this opportunity, and we have the traditional go away for a semester. We also see students take maybe a 7-day to 10-day or up to a month immersion trip, and those are individually faculty led. And finally, if you are interested in applying at all, if you are a senior, our app is still live and rolling. It's a free application. We have our regular application. We're also on the Common App. Truly, all we need to see is your high school transcripts. We are test optional for this year and for next year. Please reach out with any further questions. Have a great day.
All right, thank you so much. Next up, we have Southern Illinois University.
Hello, everyone. Let me get my screen pulled up. Okay. Can everyone see that okay? Oh, except on the wrong slide. Okay. Hi, my name is Kennedy Lloyd, and I am an admissions coordinator at Southern Illinois University Carbondale. So just to tell you a little bit about our university, we are a public research university located in Carbondale, which is actually as almost south as you can get in the state of Illinois. So we're actually closer to cities like Memphis, Nashville, and St. Louis. So just to kind of give you an idea of where we are located. So we are a smaller mid-sized public university with about 10,000 undergraduate students on campus. We do have students from literally all over the country. In addition to all over the world, we do bolster a large international student population, which makes it a lot of fun to meet people from new and exciting places. And then by the time you include our graduate, med, and law students, we have about 13,000 students who attend our university. We have over 200 programs offered in a number of different academic colleges. So probably anything that you can think of, we probably offer either a college or a program related to what you're interested in pursuing. And then we have a student to faculty ratio of 13 to 1. So even with a population of about 10,000 undergraduate students, our class sizes are still pretty small. Less than 5% of our classes are 50 students and over. Majority fall between that 20 to 30 range, with a lot of them being even smaller than 20 as well. And so with us being a research university, this makes it super important to have those smaller class sizes, because you'll really get to connect with your faculty members, unlike you would with larger classes, so that you can take advantage and learn more about the research opportunities that are happening in the department. And so undergraduates can start research as early as their freshman year. So your freshman year, you can contact your department, get involved in research. These are sometimes volunteer opportunities and sometimes even paid opportunities. So we definitely recommend that students take advantage of those opportunities so that when they graduate, not only do they have a credential with us, but they have some hands-on experience to go on that resume as well. And so some important notes about funding and those kind of things. We do not have out-of-state tuition. So as long as you are a domestic student, you are charged our in-state tuition rate. So you don't have to worry about out-of-state tuition costs. And then we also offer what's called legacy tuition rate, and that is for students whose parents graduated from SIU Carbondale. And then over 90% of our students receive some form of financial assistance, whether that's in the form of scholarships and grants. So let's talk about that. So these are some of our freshman merit-based scholarships. So whenever you apply, especially if you're applying as a true freshman straight out of high school, we really just need your high school transcript. We just wanna look at your GPA. And when we are evaluating you for your admissions decision, we're also gonna evaluate you just on your GPA for a merit-based scholarship. So our minimum GPA requirement is a 2.75. So just by meeting that minimum, you are awarded a $1,500 scholarship for each year that you attend with us. And then obviously the higher the GPA, the higher the award there. So you can kind of take a look at those. And then our highest merit-based scholarship is our University Excellence. So if you have a 3.8 or higher, you will receive a $7,500 scholarship as long as you're admitted by November 30th for every year that you attend with us for 4 years. And then after November 30th, that University Excellence is $5,500. And then by meeting that minimum GPA requirement for University Excellence, you are then invited to apply for our Chancellor Scholarship, which is our full ride, tuition, fees, room and board for 4 years. So we definitely encourage students to apply early to meet those deadlines. And then this is a breakdown of our budget right now. So overall, the estimated budget for tuition, fees, room and board is $25,500. So you can kind of put in your mind, if you know your GPA is something, go ahead and calculate maybe what your overall cost would be. And so for being a public research university, we feel like our education is very affordable and accessible. And then by the time you're admitted as well, you're also able to submit our general scholarship application, which automatically applies to you for over 600 different scholarships. So even with that merit-based scholarship, you can work to kind of increase that scholarship offer. And so we do require that freshmen live on campus for their first year with us. And so included in our housing costs that we just saw in the previous slide is our anytime meal plan. So that isn't anything that you purchase additionally. And with our anytime meal plan, it literally is anytime. So as long as they are open, you can go to either of our dining halls and get food whenever and however many times you need to get it. And so we definitely encourage students to take advantage of that service. And then also we offer what is called living learning communities. So sometimes these are population-based, or these are based out of the colleges and academic departments. So if you want to live with students who are like-minded, who are studying the same things that you are studying, you can choose to live in a living learning community so that you have that sense of community and friendship in campus in your residence halls. And so we are the Salukis, which we love because we are the only university in the country that whose mascot is a Saluki. And if you don't know, that is a type of Egyptian hunting dog. And we actually have some real life Salukis who come and visit us on campus. And that is always my favorite day whenever we get to see them. And so for athletics, we are NCAA Division I. We are part of the Missouri Valley Conference. So this is a lot of fun as well. As a student, you'll be able to attend games and all of the events surrounding games. And so we definitely encourage students to get involved in this way. And then as far as campus life and involvement, we also offer a number of different registered student organizations. The departments are constantly putting on different events. So we just encourage students to get involved and take advantage of those opportunities. And so all you need to do to apply is to submit our online application. We will be using the Common App starting this summer. We do have a $48 application fee currently. And then we just need a copy of your official transcripts. We are currently test optional, so you can ignore the note that says send your official ACT or SAT scores. And then we also encourage you, check us out on social media. I would recommend for all of the different universities that you're looking at, look at their social media. It is a really great way to learn more about the campus, the students and people there. And then also you can be a part of our Instagram challenge for Visit SIU. So if you visit campus, definitely enter that contest. And then this is my contact information here. I would love to answer more questions, learn more about your interests. So definitely contact me. And then I'm also going to be putting information about campus visits in the chat because we are currently open for campus visits. So thank you so much.
All right, thank you. Next up, we have Columbia College Chicago. Oh, you're muted.
There we go. Thank you.
Yep.
I'm Gerard from Columbia College Chicago. I'm an admissions counselor here. Just wanted to get started and show you guys. Let me move this out of the way so you guys can see the skyline here at Columbia College Chicago. So this is a basis of what our campus looks like. We are a nonprofit private institution in Chicago's South Loop neighborhood, which is downtown Chicago. So let's go here. A bit about Columbia, we are a hands-on learning environment, so we are immersed in the creative arts elements of college, so networking and career preparation are also parts of that. We have a rigorous curriculum, and we are known for collaboration. A lot of our students collaborate together along with instructors who are also still involved in their actual arts of choice. A bit about the numbers here at Columbia. We have 6,500 students plus, 1,800 being new freshmen enrolled. 42% of our students self-identify as students of color. We have a class size of less than 18 students, 12-to-1 ratio on the students to full-time faculty, and 16% of our students are first generation. So with our tuition and value at Columbia, we definitely take pride in assisting our students and helping them get to where they want to be, especially on campus, in helping with additional aid. We have our student financial services working full time around the clock for our students. So I just wanted to break down a little bit about financial aid. So a lot of that does factor into the process of getting your maximum scholarship amount. So three ways you're going to want to do that is completing your application gets you a scholarship, which is called our Columbia Scholar Award. Then also we have, if you fill out the FAFSA, you get our need-based scholarship. And then we also have, if you submit a portfolio or you audition, you get what's called a faculty recognition award. So breaking it down, these are some of the stats from this past year. 99% of our freshmen have an average packet of scholarships per the academic year of $26,199, with transfer students being 97% with $22,711. So we do have a creative learning environment. So below I have some pictures of our media production center, which has two film production sound stages. And you use those to film TV sets, things like that. If you have any shows or anything that you would like to film. We have a newly remodeled space, which is our Getz Theater Center, fabrication facility for building. So set design, we have 3D printers in there. You're able to build anything from jewelry to furniture. Our student center, which is an immersive hub for our students to collaborate as well as relax if you want to. We have practice rooms and screening rooms, gender neutral restrooms, a fitness center is also there, and event spaces for meetings and also for receptions. So a little bit about the hands-on from year one aspect of Columbia is once you get to Columbia, there's no, taking theory classes or anything like that. You're definitely able to dive into your major, your art, your interest, and your passion, and start right away in the classes. You're also able to collaborate with other students right away. There's plenty of opportunity for that at Columbia. At Columbia, we have 60 plus majors and programs, most of the aspects being in visual arts, business and management, communication and writing, media and digital arts, music and sound, performing arts. And then these are the programs listed. I'm from this element. I was a marketing major when I attended Columbia. So with career development, we do have faculty members who are, you know, definitely involved in their actual field still. So that is a way to network. And we also have a career center that you're able to utilize from the time that you're a freshman at Columbia all the way till the time that you're a senior. And from there, you can do mock portfolios or, you know, master your portfolio, create a website, build business cards for free, build a website for free, schedule up mock interviews. And we also offer job fairs on campus for students. So a bit about alumni productions from, you know, going to the Career Center has gotten people into places like Last Week Tonight with John Oliver, HBO Films, Institute of Contemporary Art Los Angeles, Saturday Night Live, Steppenwolf Theater, The Thrillist New York, Venmo, Walt Disney Studios. Those are a couple places that alumni found success. So being at Columbia College Chicago, you have access to one of the biggest hubs in the United States. And I want to say we're the second city. So you're able to, you know, not only network on campus, but off campus as well. Many students have gone on to have internships and, you know, do Broadway in the city. As well as, you know, just do set design, anything. A lot of different opportunities and a lot of opportunity to network, not just on campus, but off campus. So a bit about that is you'll be living in Chicago. So we do offer residence centers, everything from your traditional dormitory style all the way to studio lofts and, you know, 4-bedroom lofts. We have a lot of different options. It's not recommended. I mean, it's not required to live on campus for your first year, but it is recommended. That's one fact that I will also mention. So applying to Columbia, we start accepting applications in August, and we begin releasing decisions about mid-October. And then we continue accepting applications and releasing decisions on a rolling basis thereafter. And then materials can vary based on your degree type. So feel free to visit us. We're hosting safely academic visits and campus visits, on-campus visits. We're doing virtual tours, open house, one-on-one chats. And we're also doing some info sessions in town halls now. Post the links right here. So columb.edu/visit and then columb.edu/virtual. And then I just want to talk a bit about Manifest, which is our urban arts media festival in which you know, students are able to collaborate. It's a capstone festival where seniors showcase their work and students from all over, and then it's open to the public. People come from all over just to see this festival. Right now, it is virtual. Last year, we had Jamila Woods headline the festival, and she played. She is an R&B singer, and it was a great time. And thank you. I will just go ahead on and end it there. Feel free to contact at any of these links below, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.
All right, thank you. Definitely put any of that into the chat that you'd like them to have. Next up, we have Blackburn College.
All right, can you see that?
Yes.
All right, wonderful. All right, we are Blackburn College. We are located in Carlinville, Illinois. We are in a small town here in Carlinville, about an hour north of St. Louis and 45 minutes from Springfield, Illinois, which is the capital here in Illinois. Our classes average around 13 students, so you're really getting to know the people that you're studying with and that you're going to school with here at Blackburn. We have about 550 students on average here each year, and we sit on an 80-acre campus, 40 of which are athletic facilities, 40 of which are academic facilities. So you have a very spacious campus here at Blackburn. Overall, we offer 40 areas of study and everything from the social sciences, the natural sciences, and the humanities. And then on top of our studies or our areas of studies for major, we also offer 30 minors. Here at Blackburn, we are a liberal arts institution, and we do require that our students take either 2 years of Spanish or a minor in their course here at Blackburn. If you are an education major, however, because your schedule is so packed already, you do not have to take a minor. And we are known for our education here at Blackburn and the ability to get our students out to those different institutions around us. The main thing here at Blackburn is that we are a work institution. We are actually one of 8 federally recognized work institutions in the United States. And that's a little bit different than the work study programs that a lot of schools do. Our work program here is consisted entirely of students and it's run by students. So everything done here on campus is really done by our students. Any job that you see that does not have to have a professional or a professional position attached to it is done by our students. So our students really get a great opportunity to begin their working career before they ever set foot into the job world. They get to build their resumes. They get to be mentored by professional members of the community and members of our campus facility or our campus as well. And in return for our students' work, they actually get a $5,000 tuition credit. It's about 160 hours a semester that you have to work, but you do gain the experiences that you're going to need to step foot into the real world. On campus, we do have 6 residence halls. One is all male, one is all female, and 4 are co-ed. 2 of our dorms actually do not have air conditioning, and it's a way to save a little bit of money on top of the cost for schooling. We have multiple student activities for students to be involved in here at Blackburn as well. So on top of being a student and a worker here at Blackburn, a lot of our students also participate in multiple clubs and organizations outside of their required work hours and classes. We have the oldest newspaper in the state here in Illinois called the Burnian for private institutions. That we like to boast on. Our campus activity board does a really good job of keeping our students entertained throughout the week and on the weekends, planning a lot of big events, especially for the weekends, taking our students to Cardinals games and Blues games when the pandemic is not here. They'll also take them to Springfield to cultural events and really get students involved in our Carlinville community as well. We also have Student Senate here on campus, which is a big draw for a lot of our students as they are able to work with our upper administration here on campus as well. If you don't see a club here on campus that you happen to want to participate in, you can actually make your own as well and actually receive money from the Campus Activities Board to host your own events too. We are a D3 institution for athletics and you have 13 teams here on campus. Our men's basketball program actually just won the SLIAC conference championship this past weekend, so we're pretty proud of them for bringing home the trophy for that. Also, if you're not interested maybe in athletics or if you're more interested in the arts, we have multiple ways to get involved here on campus as well. Whether your talent is singing, acting, if you're artistic, there's so many ways to get involved here on campus, from anything from our choir and voices here on campus to the musicals and plays that we host, and juried art galleries for our students. And we actually have a really cool repertory theater during the summer that our students who are still here on campus actually get to act with community members who get to come in and they get to put on productions throughout the summer as well. Grants and scholarships are readily available to our students. We always encourage students to fill out the FAFSA to get as much scholarship money and grant money as they possibly can. We do award scholarships based on merit here, so we only look for your GPA, and we give you that $5,000 on top of it. So they are stackable scholarships and grants. You can find out what scholarships you qualify for going to this website, and we can talk more about it if you choose to visit. Our application is free online. We look for a 2.5 GPA in top 50% of the class. And this year we are test optional. We are planning on continuing with being test optional in the next few years as well. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out to us. You can reach out to us via email or phone, or you can get onto our website and contact us and we will get in touch with you. Thank you.
All right, thank you. If I could have all of the panelists come back on screen. Right. Same order that you presented in. We only have a few moments. So if you could quickly tell us what advice you would give someone going through the college search process, starting with Illinois College.
I would say the thing that you probably should do is look for the deal breakers that need to be at a particular school. So what I mean by deal breakers is, what is the thing or few things that you have to have in a college experience, and use that in your college search, regardless of where you're starting and where you end up, those things should be there too. So that's my advice for you.
I would definitely encourage students to get to know their admission counselor. You've already got to hear from several of us here today. We're here to make your life a little bit easier through this process. In a lot of ways, we're a one-stop shop for financial aid, next steps, all things enrollment. So get to connect with us and we'll help you out through the process.
Piggybacking off of what Andrew said, I would recommend, if you know, if you're looking into school and your family has a family friend that is a current student, or you know someone from your high school that is a current student at that institution you're looking at, utilize them. And here truly from a student's perspective, we'd love to chat with you. We want to connect with you, but hearing from a current student, I think really helps you decide if it's a place you're interested in attending.
I would say, don't be afraid to cast your net wide in your college search. I know when I was in high school and a junior and a senior, it felt like there was like three or four universities that were constantly brought up. But I would say, don't be afraid to step out and look at colleges that your friends aren't looking at or people at your high school aren't looking at. I know for me, I'm from Washington State originally, and I ended up finishing my undergrad way across the country, didn't know a single soul there, and I don't regret it for one second. So if you find somewhere that's really right for you and that really excites you, don't be afraid to take the risk.
I would say definitely take all the time that you need to take, as well as ask as many questions as you need to ask whenever pursuing on going anywhere, whether it be college or any type of university. Definitely just take your time. It's a big decision that you're going to be making for a good solid chunk of your life.
And I would piggyback off of that. Ask as many questions as you feel necessary. Don't feel like any questions are dumb questions or anything else. You don't know how to do this process, and it's your very first time doing it. So don't be shy about reaching out to the people that you've made connections with and just asking for their honest feedback about the different schools that you're looking at.
All right. I think all of that is perfect advice. And I always plug, please, please contact these folks. This is what they do. They are the experts to guide you through this process. And when you are leaving this, please know that there is a 4-question survey that you will be asked. That's very, very helpful to us. You can find a recording of this, everything that's in the chat, which is all that really important contact information is also included with that recording. And that's at strivescan.com. So thank you again to our experts, to our panelists for taking the time to share their knowledge. And thank you to all the attendees. Best of luck, stay safe, and have a good day.